Now we have had a look at Rutherford's planetary model of the atom. So soon after he had given his model, there was a slight problem with his model, which was actually pointed out by some people, some scientists. So back then it was known that I'm not going to get into too much detail, because even this, the reason and the problem with Rutherford's model is actually a bit high level, so I don't think I should get into too much detail right now. But the basic idea is that if this is the nucleus and you have the electron revolving around it, so in any orbit, so this is the orbit of the electron, just like planets have orbits and moon also has an orbit. Similarly, these electrons also have these orbits. And scientists pointed out at that time that if such an electron moves in this circular path, it should emit light, which is a form of energy. And as it emits light, because light is a form of energy, it should lose energy, right? And because it loses energy, it should slow down. And due to that, it should slowly fall. Slowly, by losing energy, it should slowly fall into the nucleus itself, because it is losing energy, and slowly it should fall into the nucleus. So I don't want to get into too much detail here, why would it lose energy and why would it fall into the nucleus and all that. But the basic idea is that they pointed out that the orbit of such an electron would not be stable, it won't last long. But obviously we know that atoms are pretty stable, because everything around us does not simply destroy like that. So atoms should be pretty stable, and so a slight problem with the this model. Then this person called Niels Bohr, just call him Bohr. So this person came and he gave his own theory. So he just added something else to the Rutherford's model to make it better and more accurate. He said that the electron cannot be in random orbits, so we cannot put it in any orbit, like just put it here randomly or maybe here. The orbits are not random, they are very precise, and only some orbits are stable. So it means that the electron cannot be present at any distance from the nucleus, it has to be at some precise distances or orbits in which it will remain stable. And if the electron is in those particular orbits, then the electron will not radiate any energy, it will not lose any energy, and it will be very stable. Now his reasons why it would happen and what those exact orbits are, those will be studied in much higher classes. But for now he said that, so let's say this is the first stable orbit, this is the second stable orbit, and let's say this is the third stable orbit. So the electron can either be in this orbit, or some electron can be in this orbit, or let's say we have more than one electrons, so the one of the electrons can be here, the second can be here, the third can be here, and you can have more than one electrons in a single orbit also. Let's say you have two electrons in this orbit, one in this and two in this two. So he said that these are the stable orbits, and the electron will revolve in these orbits without losing energy. But if the electron is, let's say, somewhere here, the electron cannot revolve in this particular orbit, in this orbit, because this is not a stable orbit. It should either be in this orbit, or this orbit, or this orbit. It cannot be in between these orbits. So that was a very simple modification in Rutherford's model, but it had huge implications. But yeah, I won't get into too much detail why and how and all that. This is the final model that we'll be sticking to for now, and for now this is our final model of the atom. So this is how basically we can visualize our atom as. This is the nucleus here, all the mass is inside this nucleus, and these are the small electrons, negatively charged electrons, inside these inside these very specific orbits. And yeah, now in the next video we'll quickly have a look at the nucleus and what it is made up of, and yeah, basics of that part. That's it for this video.